Hi, I'm Reese Samuelson, and I'm a level 9 judge from Illinois. My favorite memory from the season was being able to be a line judge at Big Ten Championships. One of the funniest memories I've had this season is all the little girls asking me, "Oh my gosh, how old are you?" And then a special shout out to Jessica Holtz and Linda McDonald for helping me through this journey on becoming a judge.
Hello everyone, my name is Annie Alameda and I'm a Missouri judge. And one of my great memories from judging is when I first started out, I went to our Missouri Judges Cup as a little newbie and was put on vault all day for 4 or 5 handsprings with Tracy Bradshaw. And she was so calm and helped mentor me and helped me understand this angle and height and distance and to truly score the kids the way they needed to be scored. And I kept that with me, and through the years, I've recently sat down with some new judges, and it came full circle. I was able to take what Tracy's taught me and help with our new judges, and it's a great learning experience. I love our judges and excited for this week. Thanks.
Hi, I'm Kay Ferguson. I'm from Wisconsin. My favorite gymnastics memory is I was invited to do the national course for the first time. As always, our printed study material was late, and so my code came, I think, only two and a half weeks before the test. At the time, I lived in an apartment, and there was a tornado warning, and I got into my bathtub, hugged my code to my chest, because I knew if everything else was lost, I could not replace this in time for my test. And I ended up saving my code. Fortunately, my apartment did not blow down, and I did make it to the course and passed.
Hi, Kim Riley, Michigan. I started by taking a judging class taught by Judy Dobrowski in 1974. She encouraged us to test, so the very first judging test, I sat there with Donna Trevathan and myself with the 8mm reel running. And on beam, I happened to glance over. I had 8-4 on the beam routine. Glanced over to Donna's paper and she had a 4-8. We started laughing, and of course, Carolyn Bowers said no laughing, no talking. But we both passed, we both got a rating. They're still going strong.
Hello, everybody. My name is Jan Adkins, and I'm from Wisconsin, and I just wanted to tell you about my first judging experience. When I was in college, I was told that the junior high down the road needed judges, and would I judge? I said, sure, what do I do? Oh, bring paper and pencil, and they'll tell you when you get there. I said, okay, great, I'm off. Bye.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the symposium. This is Tom Cole. I'm your National Junior Olympic Development Program Committee Chair and also a very strong NAWGJ member since 1980 when I had lots of hair. I still have lots of hair, but the other week I had to judge 5 sessions of Silver Floor in a row and all my hair fell out after that. I hope you guys all have a terrific symposium. I can't wait to be able to lecture and hopefully you'll learn something from me.
Hi, I'm Jasmine from Minnesota.
And I'm Mickey from Omaha.
And we just wanted to tell the story of how we met. Go ahead.
Yeah, we were judging at the Corn Palace in Mitchell, South Dakota. And we were on ball together. First time we met, ball together.
During the level 8, 9, 10 session at the South Dakota State meet.
Yes.
And there were some, we could see the bars that were up on a stage. The beautiful Corn Palace. And there were some technical difficulties and the bars ended up collapsing.
Falling down onto the judges.
Joanna
Runke and Angie Jensen were up there.
In memory. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And
so then there was the question of how are the athletes going to
finish bars?
So they ended up getting a bus rented, and the athletic trainer was the one who was driving the athletes
back
into a gym off-site to compete bar.
And it was snowing.
It was a snowstorm. Yeah. As always. And then they streamed it in like the big camera up top. So the parents could watch their kids compete bars.
In the Corn Palace, they streamed it.
Yes. So I think a thank you to the Corn Palace for
bringing us together
and a thank
meeting
you
new friends yes
meeting new friends and a thank you to Linda Thorberg, who was very busy with petitions that weekend because of the bars.
Hi, my name is Kylie Fortunato. I'm from Minnesota. And for me, judging is a bit of a family affair. My husband is a men's judge. My father-in-law and brother-in-law also judge men's gymnastics. So it's been a real blessing to our family to get to judge, do something that we really enjoy, and bring in a little extra income.
Good morning. My name is Cindy Burr, and I'm from the great state of Wisconsin. I have something to show you today. Watch carefully. That is part of the uneven bar routine that I did as a freshman in high school in 1972. In 1972, Title IX was also passed, and it was passed to give girls and women an equal opportunity to participate in sports. That was 50 years ago. As I've watched over the past 50 years, I am amazed at what girls and women have been able to do once they've been given a chance. We can prove that we're strong, fast, powerful, and we too can be athletes. Thank you, Title IX.
Come on.
Oh, gosh. So pretty. Wow, really, it's so wrapped.
Oh my God.
Being a NAWGJ member is really special, but being in Pennsylvania and a NAWGJ member, there are some lessons you must learn right away.
Lesson number one, you must go to symposium every single time, no matter where it is, no matter how long you've been judging, whether that be 2 days or 25 years. In my case, my first symposium was 9 months after I started judging, and regardless of how much money you have in the bank, this was told to us by your SJD at the time, and we haven't missed one yet.
Lesson number two, on your way to a clinic, if there is a winery and you almost miss it, don't slam on your brakes, slide into that winery, get the wine, and continue your journey to the clinic. A lesson taught thanks to Patty Vitale on our way to Woodward for the high performance clinic.
Lesson number three, you have to work your way up the judging ratings as quickly as possible. That might mean taking all three judging exams in the same day, compulsories, and both parts of optionals. And in my case, my first optional test ever at symposium after sitting in clinics for 2 days. This was told to us by our SJD at the time. And then when we got to symposium, she wanted to know why we were doing this all at the same time. It was in fact her fault.
Lesson four. If your state does a white elephant gift exchange during Christmas, do not be the one to get caught with the same hideous golden necklace year after year after year.
Lesson number five, there are rain delays in gymnastics. When judging virtually during COVID on Barb Cotillo's deck, we had to run inside promptly when her retractable roof started to recede so all of our devices wouldn't get wet.
Sixth and final lesson of PA NAWGJ, we are friends. Gymnastics is a passion that pulls us together, but it is through gymnastics that we truly become friends.
I'm Jen Dittmer. I currently live in Dayton, Ohio, but part of my story is that I have lived in all four time zones in the U.S. and have judged in, I think, four different regions. So everywhere, every time I moved, it was a little bit scary, but I knew that I would find gymnastics judges and gymnastics judging, which I did, and every place was great.
And one of the things that I remember most was being at a conference meet in Michigan. And there were a bunch of us from all over the country, and we just went and, you know, sat at the bar and in the restaurant to kind of gather and have a drink. And I think the basketball tournament was on TV, and we were all talking, and the bartender looked at us and said, "Do you guys all know each other?" And one of the judges said, "No, but we all speak the same language." And I thought, that's exactly right. That's what makes it cool.
Hello, I'm Gina Fuller. I'm from St. Louis, Missouri.
And I'm Lisa Horn from St. Louis, Missouri also.
And we were just talking about different situations when meets have been interrupted. So we had one years ago that we were in the meet. It was, of course, winter and cold. And somebody's pepper spray went off in the middle of the meet. And so what happened was that we had to open all the doors, and it took a very long time to get it all cleared out. And so that made for an exciting meet.
And we had a meet where there was a protest that apparently was going to kind of parade through the meet and just slightly disturbing things. We also had a meet recently where we had to evacuate everybody, and there was a tornado warning going on, so we all went to the shelter.
So you never know what's going to happen.
Okay. Hi, I am Carol Valerie from Nebraska, and I want to say congrats to NAWGJ for our 50th anniversary. I've been judging for many years, and when I first started, I didn't really know how valuable NAWGJ was going to be, but then since then, I've moved to several different states, and it's amazing how you just get encompassed right into that location, and you get assignments right away, and you meet lifelong friends. So I appreciate the things that NAWGJ does for us, and all the training and all the hard work that volunteers do. So anyway, congrats again. Thanks. Bye.
I'm going to tell you about a time way back when pantyhose and skirts were what you wore to judge, and we were trying to balance our work from two or three different jobs, trying to get to the meet on time, and I'm changing clothes in the car. I have everything done except the pantyhose. Got one foot in. As the traffic slowed, I put the other one in. And just as I was getting ready to pull them up, I pulled over to the side at a stoplight, and there was nothing but a cement abutment to the left of me. And just as I got them up over my hips, knock, 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 there was Santa Claus at the window waiting for a donation for Christmas. I gave him enough a donation, so I put it in drive and I left.
When the rule first came out that they had bonus vaults, I was head judge for our level 10 state meet. And it was the second day before we had anybody do a bonus vault. And as soon as it was announced, I looked to all four of the judges and I went, bonus eligible. So the girl did the vault and I said, bonus. And flashed the score. As we walked down to the other end, the judge who was on the same side as I was said, "What did you take on that vault anyway?" And I said, "Well, I took a 10th on this and a 10th on that." "Well, how did you get that score?" And I said, "I forgot to give the bonus."
This is a tribute to Ginger Ahrens, the first SJD of Texas. Ginger has been an encourager and motivator to judges, coaches, and athletes with whom she shared her time, energy, and love. Her first high school team that she sponsored would like to give her a shout out, and we were all inspired by this special lady.
Hi, I'm Timmy Biggs, and I've done dance and gymnastics since I was 3. And so I contributed a lot of my success from the first job I had with Ginger Ahrens at Texas Tumbleweed. She was my first employer. And so with her guidance and encouragement to me, I moved on and kept going forward in gymnastics and dance. And so I have gone from coaching all levels, gone all the way through coaching Olympians and all the way through to being on national staff and many, many jobs and everything. And I attribute because I came through her with her willingness to help everybody and to be help people go forward. And it's just wonderful. And so it's a great experience. The office used to say, what's in the water in San Angelo? Because we had Carol, Cheryl, we had me, that all were in gymnastics. And we had a bunch of people that goes on and on the list that comes from San Angelo, Texas and West Texas. And a lot of it, I think, goes to Ginger for what she gave to the community and she gave to us. And we followed through with it. So thank you, Ginger. You've been wonderful and love you.
Hi, this is Cheryl Jarrett, and I'm here as one of the 3 West Texas amigos. That's right, from San Angelo, Texas. There were 3 of us, and we want to say thank you to our mentor, Ginger Ahrens, as a judge and longtime friend from San Angelo. Ginger has inspired and helped many other people and judges as the SJD and all the other things she did. But that was only the beginning. As a mentor and a friend, she inspired Tammy Biggs, Carol Williams, and myself. And think how many people have been touched just by what she did to help us. We hope you all have a great symposium.
I'm Carol Williams, former SJD of Texas. Ginger inspired me to volunteer in different positions in the Gymnastics Association of Texas, the USAG Board, and NAWGJ as a signer and SJD. When Ginger first began, times were different. The files were done on index cards or on a Rolodex for the membership. Assignments were made by using the telephone that we had to call individually instead of simply clicking a button. Tests were done on her projector at the Texas Tumbleweeds. She was always helping someone that wanted to learn. My fondest memory of Ginger was judging a high school meet with her. She had just had foot surgery and drove all the way from San Angelo, Texas to judge these kids. When they called her name in the introductions, the gymnasts started to clap as they all stood up and the coaches stood up, the parents stood up, the whole audience and the whole arena stood up and cheered for Ginger. And it was the most moving moments of my life. Ginger planted many seeds for a lot of people, and I'm sure that you have someone that's special to you. Please let them know how much they meant to you and that we may follow their example by planting as many positive seeds as possible. Thank you, Ginger. And thank you, Winnie Witten and Cheryl DeWeard, for helping me to make this video.
From Huntsville, Alabama, and I've had some interesting experiences traveling. I was at a clinic and we stayed in a hotel. I was with another judge, and in the middle of the night we found that some mice came into our room and got into our luggage. And one of the things they got into was had a little Ziploc bag of vitamins, and that the mice tried to eat my vitamins. And so they were very healthy mice, and you just never know what you're going to experience when you travel judging.
Hello, I'm Jeannie Johnson. I'm from near Chicago in Illinois. And I'd have to say some of my fondest memories of the ladies that have mentored me and have given me support and reassurance over the years. And we were just talking about Alice Childers, who's my first meet referee at NCAA Regional. And she kind of walked me through everything and helped me with everything. And then we were talking about Lois, and I think it was Carson at the time, Lois Colburn, was one of my meet refs at another NCAA Regional. And I just remember being young and fresh and kind of new. And she took me to lunch, and I felt very comfortable and very reassured that I was going to be there.
Hi, I'm Mark Welch. I'm a longtime gymnastics judge from Eldred, Pennsylvania. I have a couple stories to tell about this. For one thing, I actually started judging when I was 14. You were supposed to be 16. We didn't know that until actually after I took the test and people realized, why wasn't I driving? But anyway, at one point, I was actually 15 years old and I was judging college gymnasts that were all older than me. One of my other favorite stories is I was actually judging balance beam with Carol Ide, and we had a gymnast that was on the beam for 2 minutes and 42 seconds, and she actually started getting an argument with her coach, who was trying to pull her off, and she would not get off. So I love the sport, love all the other judges. It's really enriched my life.
Hi, my name is Donna Shuey, and I am from Northern California. I've been judging since the mid-70s, and my first experience in college judging for regionals was at LSU. And Betty Stroud was her last competition. She was going to be judging, so we were going to go out and celebrate afterwards. But we got to the meet site, and it was like right when the meet, you know, they're setting up for it, they realized that the track team took the computer with them to Texas for a track competition. So they ended up doing the whole competition on an Excel spreadsheet, and we were at the competition site forever waiting for them to do the results. And we finally got the results, signed them off, and then we went back about midnight, had Betty's party, and then we got up at 4 a.m. and flew home. So those are great memories and reasons why we all still do gymnastics.
All right, my name is Amy Duguid. And one story that I always think about was the first time that I got an assignment. Well, actually, I was a sub, two subs for somebody, for bars for the first time. And it was at the University of Utah. And I had previously been an athlete at that location. And so we get there, and there's 15,000 people. I'm nervous. And they're telling the head judges, you know, some things to do and this and that. And I'm not the head judge. I'm just nervous. I'm not listening. We go out on the floor and the other judge looks at me and she goes, "You're the head judge." And I just, wow, it was overwhelming. And first girl up fell and I survived through that. But anyway, that was a good memory.
Where do you live, Amy?
Oh, sorry. I live in Gainesville, Florida.
Wonderful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm Jody Borda. I'm from Ohio. And I was a gymnast at Miami University. And they would call and ask for a gymnast to come and judge a Y meet or a high school meet. So I would go and realize I had no idea what I was doing. So I found out Betty Shrovey was nearby, was giving clinic. So I went, and that's how I actually started judging. And then I tested, and here I still am. 49 years later.
Hi, I'm Denise Cutts Laureate, and I'm from Dallas, Texas. And I guess I should share with you that this is my 50th year to judge. So I've had lots of great experiences. I started way back when I was in college as a gymnast and at Penn State. And I've been judging in Texas ever since. I coached high school for 37 years, and now I'm retired and I just judge.
Hi, Kathy Crawford, Auburn, Washington. I grew up in Eugene, Oregon, and in 1972 they had the Olympics, and I saw Olga Corbett, and I just couldn't wait to go out at my uncle's backyard and try and do a kip on the swing set. I had no idea what I was doing, But I started junior high the next year, and I got into a gymnastics program in my middle junior high, and I've been doing it ever since. And I got to meet Olga Corbett in about 1989 or something, and so it was pretty cool. That's why.
Hi, I'm Lori DeFrancesco from Connecticut. And my story begins the first time I ever judged NCAA Nationals. I was so excited. After we left the judges' room where we practiced judge, we went out on the floor. And as I was getting my stuff ready, I realized I left my notebook that I judge in the judges' room. And the lights went out and the fire went up and I didn't want to leave. So I asked my runner if she knew where the judges were and she said, no. And so I told her what happened. She goes, do you want me to go ask for paper? And I'm like, no. But thankfully I had Crystal's newsletters. So the very first time I judged NCAA Nationals on beam, I used the back of Crystal's newsletters.
Hi, I'm Kendra Graham. I'm from Arizona, and one of my favorite gymnastics memories was when I was a little kid. We had a USA versus Romania meet, and Nadia Comăneci competed in it, and we were able to be on the floor to do a ribbon routine during the meet. And my most interesting memory of that was Nadia was jumping up and down right in front of me, and I actually tapped her on the leg and told her to get out of the way. That's about it.
Thank you. This is about another judge whom I will not name, but she was from our region in Michigan. And this person went to judge a college meet, and she walked out to put her papers down. And as she stood there, her skirt fell to the ground. Fortunately, she did have a slip on. Of course, the college guys just hooted and hollered. And being the compassionate friends that we all were, when we heard about it, we sent her a package of safety pins.
I'm Candace Alvey, and I'm from Kentucky. I'm presently the SJD. I began judging in the 90s. I've been judging about 30 years, and my most memorable story is the very first time I ever judged Carol Lidke. She is the one that got me into judging and my mentor. I was with her on floor at the biggest meet Kentucky ever had. All of my judging friends told me that whatever my score was, to drop it 5/10 and I would be in range with her. So the first routine goes, and I thought, I'm just going to give it a try and just do my own score. So I look up and she calls me over. I thought, crud, I should have, you know, dropped 5/10. Well, I was a point lower than her. And she informed me that there would be worse routines. And so the next routine was up and it was much worse. And she looked over across the floor at me and said, I told you so. And that is my memorable memory.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Diane Grayson from Arizona. And I was at an invitational, long day. It was the end of the day. I was a little tired, got back to my desk to get ready to judge, and got out my red lip stain to put on my lips to perk me up a little bit and follow it with a lip gloss. And I started putting on the red lip stain, and the national anthem came on. So I put my little mirror and my lip stain away, listened to the national anthem, sat back down, and went to put my lip gloss on, because it holds the stain on, and got that done, looked at my timer to see if she was ready. She's giving me this look. I don't know, whatever. So I went to put the lip gloss on, and it wasn't the lip gloss, but I didn't know because I didn't have the mirror. So that went all over, and boy, were my cheeks and lips red that day.
Annalie Olson, and I'm from Utah. I started gymnastics because I wasn't particularly that athletic. I was always the last kid, you know, chosen for the kickball team or whatever. But we had a student teacher at our school that was taught gymnastics, and it was finally something I could do better than all the other kids. And so that's why I started. And then I got addicted.
Hi, my name is Darren Renner. I'm from Boston, Massachusetts. I have a funny story. I was judging a competition, and my secondary official went to reach and grab the cards. And as she was doing so, her bosom hit the nipple on my wheelchair, which controls my wheelchair, set me up onto the floor exercise along with the judging table. She thought it was me. So that's my funny story.
Thank you very
You're
much.
Welcome.
And tell us your name.
Joan Gelbie. Okay, I just wanted to thank Florida for welcoming me as a judge. I judged in New York for 35 years, and then I came down here and joined, and everybody's been so kind and welcoming. I have tons of meets. I really love it, and people have been so nice. So thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Sally Buchanan. I got into judging when I started, when I graduated from college. I took an adult gymnastics course, and Tim Madure recommended me, oh, you should learn to judge. Never told me what to study, what I had to do. I went and took a test. I knew the compulsory routines, but had no idea of optionals. So Lois Colburn, I think she had mercy on me, took me under her wing, and I went to the Tufts course every semester and learned how to judge appropriately and passed the test. It's been, yeah, it's been so much fun.
I was judging JO Nationals. We were in Oklahoma, and I was going out to put my papers on my table before the meet started, and I caught my heel, back when we wore skirts all the time, my heel on a cord that had not yet been taped down, and fell and broke my right hand. Now I'm right-handed. I had some friends who said to me, you can't judge, you can't judge, and I said, you think I'm going to go up to Cheryl Hamilton and Audrey Schweier and go, I can't judge nationals. My hand hurts. So I judged.
Hi, I'm Rose Castelline, and I judge in Florida. And one of my best memories was starting out as a judge in Ohio, Region 5, and then I was very nervous about moving to Florida. And I just want to thank the Florida judges for being so inviting.
Hi, I'm Jackie Fain. I took my first judging test in 1992 when my daughter was 6 months old, and at the time I lived in Iowa. My mentor at the time was Marianne West. She's the one that talked me into judging and took me under her wing, and I know a lot of you people in this room know Marianne very well. And so she just was a very special lady to me and helped me along so well and made me a great judge, actually, and taught me shorthand, taught me how to notate. So I have great memories of Marianne and fun times with her back in Iowa.
Hi, I'm Meg Dockstader, and I'm from Portland, Oregon.
I'm Amanda Turco, and I'm from Southern California.
And I've been judging for about 35 years, and I just learned something today. Amanda, tell them what I learned.
I was a gymnast at Oregon State, and Meg judged me all the time. I do not know how we connected, but she said, you need to be a judge. She told me I needed to get my level 10, because I had been an elite, so I got to test a level 10 right away, that I need to do it in 1997. And why? Because of the cycle. Yes. I missed it. So I was a level 10 for 11 years, but Meg had no idea that she was pretty much the main reason that I started judging.
So my pitch to all of you judges out there who have been doing this forever is it's so important that we invite and bring in the next generation of former athletes, amazing gymnasts, get them into the judging realm and let it take hold, and that's our future.
Perfect.
Hi, I'm Ricky Stakem. I'm from Maryland. I think one of my favorite memories was Myra Elfenbein's surprise 80th birthday party because it was so many judges and coaches from several different decades, and we all got dressed up. We didn't wear our judging uniforms or our coaching gear, and we all just came together, and even though maybe not all of us always got along on the floor, we really got along that night, and I think ever since then, we've all just really been really good friends. So that was just such a good moment for Maryland gymnastics. But we also have people from out of state too, so it was a really nice time.
Hi, I'm Jan Iman. I'm from Whitney, Texas, and I'm going to relate to you how I got started in judging. I was first a collegiate coach, and I didn't care very much for the judging. I thought they were actually stupid. And a friend of mine who was also coaching a team, Southern Connecticut, told me that I probably should just start judging. I said I was not going to happen. However, with the urgency of my husband and this particular good friend of mine, I said, okay. So I tested class 3 in May. I tested class 2 in the summer. And then this friend of mine gave me the class 1 exam in January. At the end of February, she called me up and she said, well, I just have to tell you that you've been placed on class 1 regionals and you're on a panel with Marilyn Cross vaulting. I got to go, bye. And she hung up. And I sat on the edge of the bed thinking, oh my business, what have I done? However, I went to that regional meet and I did that event with Marilyn Cross. And I understood then that she was a very smart woman. I learned a lot from her. And over the years, I have clearly come to appreciate the hard work and the diligence and the education and the professionalism that we bring to the sport and the love that we bring to the sport. And that's really the most important
thing. Thank you, Jan.
My name is Pat Faulkner. Originally in Region 6, but I'm now in Region 8. And when I was in Region 6, I have very fond memories of Gail McGann, who got me into judging, as well as Diane Cote Burke, who was very influential for me, and my friend Mary Lou Smith, and of course, the head honchos, Kathy Osberg and Kathy Feldman, Patty Panichis, were very influential, very kind. It was a really nice place to start judging.
Hi, I'm Christina Rinaldi from New York. I'm a national judge now. I've been judging, this is my 26th year, but one of my stories from judging was my first big championship meet. It was Big Tens, and I was very intimidated. I didn't know anybody there, and there were a lot of women talking about being at the ranch and with Caroli, and I just was standing there like sweating, like really nervous, and I was on beam. And I don't know, we go and this girl breaks her leap series and I was having a heart attack. I don't know what to do. And I'm like, oh my God, what do I do? What do I do? Do I break it? Do I break it? I broke it. What do I do? I'm sweating. I'm so nervous. Everybody's waiting for my score. And I'm like, all right, I'm going to break it. So I broke it and I look up and the head judge broke it. The other two women didn't break it, but the head judge broke it. So it made me feel really good.
Hi, I'm Robin Ruig from Minnesota. And one of my favorite memories was the day that Linda Thorberg and I flew the airplane. We went up to a North Dakota state meet, and they came in, some private pilots came and flew us to the state meet. On the way home, there was just one pilot. He invited us into the cockpit, and we each took turns flying the airplane.
My name's Patricia Leiden. I'm from Florida, and I would like to just say a thank you to Pamela Sherwood from Florida, who has been an outstanding ethics chair for our board and has done so much behind the scenes work that people just don't realize. And her term is ending and there'll be big shoes to fill. Thank you, Pam.
I'm Chrissy Ervesty from Iowa, and my story is before I was judging, I was working at a gym who was hosting regionals and they needed a timer for beam, but I was not wearing the appropriate attire. So Marianne West said, I have an extra jacket with me. And so she stuck her Big Naj jacket over the top of me and I timed beam with my regional shirt underneath my Naj jacket.
One time I came to the meet without a uniform because of a flight thing and Linda called, Linda Thorberg called Wisconsin judges and said, hey, Robin needs a uniform jacket because hers got lost in the flight. And so they brought me Robin Berg size jackets. She was quite a bit larger at that time.
Hi, Atkins.
And I'm Cindy Burke.
For those of you that don't know, our good friend and fellow judge Judy Schock, who many of you also know as well, has decided to retire from the world of gymnastics. And unfortunately, and so sad for us, she will be hanging up her judging jacket. Those of us in Wisconsin, as well as all of us in Region 4, will truly miss her.
For many years, we have benefited from her depth of knowledge and her willingness to mentor all. We would like to thank her for her commitment and contribution to our sport.
Judy, we wish you the best. I'm super.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Alan Whiteberg. I'm from Boston, Massachusetts. I'm a physician and also a judge, but I loved taking our tests. However, I took the 7-8 test, which required more studying than when I took my medical boards, and I was so happy to have passed that the first meet I went to, the chief judge came in the morning and said, okay, level 8, I can't remember. So I went and stood in front of her. I said, 4 A's and 4 B's. She said, sit down and shut up. And I went, oh my God, nobody ever talked to me like that. But I stuck with it, and I love judging.
So, thank you, Alan.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Mary Jo. I'm from Virginia, Northern Virginia area. And my story, I've been judging for about 30 years. And when I started judging, I was put with Sandy Oldham as one of my mentors, and I had to judge my first 3 meets with her. Well, every time I would do something wrong or my shorthand was off, she would kick me under the table. And by the second weekend that we judged together, I had a lump that now started bleeding. She kicked me so much every time I got something wrong. So I was forced to have great shorthand. I was forced to take the correct deductions. And so that's my funny judging story. And we will miss Sandy, and we are very sad.
Thank you, Mary Jo. What is your last name?
My last name is Rohrig.
Thank you, Mary Jo.
Hi, this is Hillary Carlson. I have some funny stories to tell about judging. And the first one I'll tell has to do with our own cookie batch. She used to live in Illinois, and probably in the 80s, I was practice judging with her one day. And in the middle of a routine, they announced over the loudspeaker, a brown van with a license plate, da 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 da, is being towed without looking away from the gymnast and still judging. Cookie just said to me, "That's my van." Way to go, Cookie.
Kevin McNamara.
Mm-hmm.
My very first time I ever made it to JO Nationals, I wanted to compete a layout suit, but it was not in the code of points. And so during warm-ups, my coach was able to get it petitioned so that we were allowed to do it because it had never been done before.
Carmen Soderstrom.
Okay. And how did you get into judging?
Kathy Stunkel needed an extra judge on a meet, and my mother voted me to come and judge.
That mother right there? And Kevin, how did you start judging?
My mother. She figured it was a job I could probably handle.
Her mother made her do it.
My name is Kathy Stunkel. It's been 40 years I've been judging.
Wow.
And the reason I got into judging was not, sounds funny, not really to judge. I was a YMCA program director way, way back when. And my kids finally started to get good and better. And I went, well, wait a minute, I need to help these kids. And so when I was a coach, I really didn't know what the deductions were. So how could I really know what they need to do to get better? So I went, I know what I'll do. I'll go take that judging test. And that's why I did it. I was a good coach, but I was such a much better coach because I knew the most important part, because, you know, we take kids to meets to get a score. So I wanted to know how the judges got there. And that's why I did it. And now I do it just because I enjoy it.
Hi. I was fortunate enough to be assigned to championships of the USA, and the athletes were on a podium. The route for the judges was not straight. A conference was called after bars. I grabbed my pencil and my notebook, and I raced to the meeting. It was a little long. TV was rolling. And I ran back to my seat, grabbed my judging supplies, worked my way around the cameras, and the route became an absolute maze. The green light was on. I slipped into my seat as Shannon Miller mounted the beam. I was right on the average. It was not until I got home and found out that I was on TV as the judge who obviously didn't get the memo.